Welcome to TechSimpler Studios. So here are 11 useful things you can do with an old computer. This video applies to nearly all computers from around the early 2000s or later, but this is the kind of PC I'll be talking about. It's a 2008 HP PC meant for office work, and it represents the average old family PC from the mid to late 2000s. It sports a Quad Q6600, 4GB of DDR2 RAM, a 240-watt power supply, and onboard graphics provided by the relatively slow Intel Q33 chipset. But without further ado, let's get onto the video. So the first useful thing you could do with an old PC like this is actually to use it as your second daily driver. It may seem like a bit of a direct and overlookable idea at first, but there are actually a lot of benefits to having two systems ready to use. For example, if you have older programs that won't run on your newer computer, you can run them on a computer like this, provided that you install, say, Windows XP, Vista, or 7, or OS X Snow Leopard if you're on the Mac side. These operating systems, in tandem with older hardware, will also allow you to run those old but awesome games that just don't run on Windows 10 or the latest version of macOS. And that's a decent amount of older games. Older games just feel better on older hardware too. Something about playing Need for Speed Underground 2 on Windows XP and a Pentium 4, or Trackmania Nations Forever on a Core 2 Quad just feels right. Personally, older apps and games are what I primarily use older computers for. I also use them to back up all my old CDs and DVDs. There's a great piece of software called ImageBurn that lets you do this. But back on topic. Another advantage of using your older computer as a secondary daily driver is that you could split up your tasks between computers, and even rooms if you so desire, as you could reserve one computer for, say, writing emails, creating documents, and playing those games you haven't played in years, while you save your newer computer for more resource-intensive tasks. Expanding off of this, you can install a distro of Linux on your older computer, and not only would it be much snappier, but you could also install and try software you never could have run on Windows. Some distros can even run on PCs with less than 100 megabytes of RAM. Even if you decide to stay on Windows, you can use the PC to try software and browse the web with less concern about viruses infecting your main PC. Still be careful though, as viruses and malicious programs can transfer across your network and even through the cloud. Another cool thing you can do with an old PC is that you can use it to make your TV smart. Or, if it's already smart, even smarter. To do this, you'll need to see if your computer has an HDMI port. It most likely won't, and neither does this one. You'll have to purchase a cheap graphics card like this that has an HDMI output on it and also fits into the motherboard. If you have a PC from the early to mid 2000s, you'll most likely need an AGP card, and if you have a PC from the mid to late 2000s, a PCIe card will probably work. To be sure though, you'll need to see what slot your computer has. So, if you have a wireless keyboard and mouse with a computer connected to your TV, not only can you access pretty much every streaming service, but you can also stream any game from your main PC to it to play it from the couch. If, like my HP, your computer doesn't have Wi-Fi, you'll have to buy an external USB Wi-Fi dongle. Make sure it's fast enough though if you want to stream games. In addition, there are TV-style remotes you can buy for your PC, and you can download a home theater PC program that will allow the computer to be optimized for use with one. There are also Linux distributions built solely for the purpose of being installed on a home theater PC that you can use as well. Back on the topic of gaming, despite what you might think, and depending on how old your computer is, it may still be up to the task of playing modern games with just a few upgrades. I upgraded a similar PC to the one shown before with a faster Core 2 Quad Q6600, a GTX 1050, and 6GB of DDR2 RAM, and it manages to run most relatively modern games quite well. I've actually benchmarked this exact system in my Windows 7 vs. 10 video, so go check it out if you want to see how well this system performs. You can also click the card I just popped in at the top right. The CPU will most likely hold the computer back from being able to play the latest AAA titles, but with a few upgrades, you may be able to make yourself a pretty good secondary gaming PC for a tiny sliver of what it would have cost to build a new one from scratch. Of course, if you don't want to upgrade it, you can still use it as a retro gaming machine, as I mentioned earlier. You can also use it to host a dedicated server for a game, so you and whoever you're playing with can play together without having to join a public server or pay to use an online server. Also, if you like the idea of a server but want to apply it to your files, there's also the option of allowing the PC to function as a network-attached storage device, in which all the other devices on the network can see the data on the PC's hard drive. It can act as a sort of USB drive that's accessible from all computers, making it easy to share files between devices. But if you still have no use for your old computer, don't throw it away. You can save lives with it. Using a program like Boink or Folding at Home, with literally just the click of a button once you've downloaded the program, you can use your computer's CPU and/or GPU power, even if it's an old computer, to help find medical and scientific breakthroughs. Even if it seems like your computer isn't doing much, it still could be the one that finds a cure for a major disease. I'd say making the world a better place is a lot better option than leaving plastic and metal to rot in a landfill. If you really just don't want it, though, make a YouTube video about it. There are definitely other people curious about the particular specs of your old computer. Once you've done that, you can put its hard drive in your main computer to expand its storage, provided it's a SATA drive, and potentially save any other parts that may be useful to you in the future as well, such as the case or power supply. If you want to see all of my videos where I test if various operating systems and pieces of tech are obsolete, check out my channel. There are tons of videos you would enjoy. Otherwise, thanks for watching. Like this video if it helped you, and subscribe for more tech videos like this. Also, don't forget to check out my automotive channel, TechSemplar Garage. See you all in the next video.